Here are some of the insanely cool gadgets and gizmos you may have missed in the brand new Toyota Tundra. One interior aspect, which is a little bit unusual on the new Tundra, is the selector for four-wheel drive. It's not a knob up here on the dashboard. It's not an old school lever. It's actually this little slider down here by the shifter. That's right, it's a sliding mechanism. Now, right now we're in two-wheel drive or rear-wheel drive. To go into four-wheel drive, I can't simply push back on the slider. I have to push down and then back. So it's got a little lockout mechanism, and then it will engage four-wheel drive high, and then same thing to go into low range. And that beep is to let you know that you have to put the transmission into neutral. But a little bit unusual that you can't even go between 2 and 4 high without first engaging the lockout and then pushing forward or backwards. Next up has to be the startup sequence. So this model is a limited TRD off-road Tundra. It says TRD on this red start button, but when you push in on the start button, check out the gauge cluster. A really elegant animation. It says Tundra, it says iForce Max, and then the fully digital gauge cluster comes to life.
This video was made possible by our friends at Manscaped. Christmas comes early when you get the new performance package from manscaped.com. The new Lawnmower 4.0 is waterproof and it has replaceable ceramic blades. It's also got an LED headlight and wireless charging. And the Performance Pack 4.0 bundle gets you stocking stuffers like ball deodorant and ball toner to sweeten the deal. All the while, this Weed Whacker nose and ear hair trimmer takes care of any mess above the collar. For a limited time, you'll also get 2 free gifts because it tis the season, a shed travel bag, and the anti-chafing pair of boxer briefs come free when you order with our promo code. To get the gift that keeps on giving, try the Peak Hygiene Plan so you never run out. Don't wait, go to manscaped.com and use the promo code FASTLANETRUCK to get 20% off, plus free international shipping, plus 2 free gifts. I think you know what presents you need under your tree this holiday.
One thing I really don't understand is when you go to move the power seat, the truck beeps at you. I'm really curious as to why that is. I've never seen any other vehicle where you move the seat, the truck actually lets you know that the seat is moving. I know clearly it is moving because I'm moving, but just kind of an odd feature.
Another really cool feature in the Tundra is the turbo and max gauge. Now the max gauge is of course your hybrid assistance, and the iForce is your turbo pressure. And then when you accelerate, it not only shows you the assistance from the hybrid system, but also from the turbo, and then you've got like a little battery gauge there too. And actually it sounds pretty good. Not a bad sounding truck at all.
I really appreciate how Toyota has incorporated the fog lights into the front end of the Tundra, because so often fog lights are just something that are there, but they don't look really cool and they're not well incorporated into the front fascia. But on the Tundra, the fog lights are these 2 LED strips located down here underneath the grill. And what I like about them is they look almost aftermarket, but in a good way. Like you incorporated 2 aftermarket LED light bars neatly into the front end of the Tundra, but they're not just there hanging out, they actually have a really nice look to them. Now I wanted to show you the Pro, the Tundra TRD Pro, and this one not only has the fog lights, but it also has the off-road TRD light bar. Let me show you how that works. All right, so first things first, let's turn on the main beam on the headlights, but when you go to click the TRD light bar button down here by your left knee, it just blinks at you and doesn't turn on, and that's because it's programmed, so it only comes on when the brights are on. So let's go ahead and turn on the brights. And then we can click on the light bar. And there you have it. Not only are the high beams illuminated, but so is that light bar. Also, I love the marker lights on this truck, the TRD marker lights. They just look fantastic. The interior of the Pro is accented across the board in orange and red contrasting colors. Of course, you do get TRD emblems throughout, over here on the steering wheel, down here on the shifter, in the back of the seats, TRD Pro. But my favorite TRD Pro feature in here is not the little stripe on the steering wheel, but the Toyota script across the passenger side, of course, accented in red. It just looks phenomenal. Another really nice touch they have done to the TRD Pro is this almost camo pattern on the fender flares. Very unusual. I don't know if I've seen another truck that does this, but depending on the trim, not only do you get a different flare, but a different pattern, and it just looks really premium. Looks fantastic, especially against the orange. I don't know if it comes out on video, but there's definitely kind of a almost urban camo pattern in there. One feature of the Tundra that is well integrated is the manual selection for the gear indicator and the positioning of the shifter. So into drive, over to S, and then you can of course set a gear limit by shifting up and down. Now this is a gear limit. This is not like a paddle shifted vehicle. So for example, if I go into S3, the transmission will shift between first, second, and third gear, but lock out at third, S4, 1, 2, 3, and 4. And then of course that is to assist in long grades down a mountain, maybe when you're towing a load, so you could lock out into third or fourth gear at the max. That can be confusing to some car folks, but look how prominent the selector is on the instrument cluster. It's large and in charge and very easy to see. I love that Toyota has made that so clear. Lots and lots of fine details and touches in the new Toyota Tundra that are very well thought out. For example, the design of the volume control, and then of course the little drive selector down here as well. Very, very high quality controls. They're not just a standard knob. They actually have like little indents where they're supposed to have, you know, a little screw head. Those are of course just visual, but I like the ribbing on the side. They feel fantastic and a huge leap forward in terms of material quality over the previous generation. Toyota has integrated the trailer brake controller down here below the start stop button. Very easy to access, just to the right of the steering column. You of course have your buttons for gain. It's easily accessible and it feels pretty good to touch. It is a little odd to me that we have all of our driver controls down here, multi-terrain select. We also have crawl control, but the rear locker is actually up here on the dash. I think it would be better if there was a separate button down here for that rear locker, but at least it's a toggle and these toggles feel truly awesome. Oop, wasn't happy about that. Let's check out the camera views while we're at it. Full 360 degree camera views, which I am realizing are not showing up on the camera. I'm gonna have to get a different camera out, one sec. All right, check this out. When you click the view button down here, look at this 360 degree camera the computer puts together about the truck's positioning. So you can see that I'm parked underneath this tree. That tree shows up here on this little 360 degree animation, but it looks like the truck is slammed. Look at that. What a weird thing. The screen on the new Tundra really is phenomenal. I'm not even talking about the size and the quality. This is the optional 14-inch screen, of course, but the usability is just so much better than the previous generation trucks. Very quick, very easy to use. All the icons are super easy to navigate. We've got these shortcuts along the left side of the screen. Just is one of the best displays in the industry now. Really have improved it in a big way, and Toyota should be proud of the work they have accomplished on the usability of the UI. The USB port situation is a little bit odd in the new Tundra, so the first and most prominent USB port is up here on the dash panel itself next to the climate control. And then when you go to look for others, they're not immediately apparent until you slide back on this little panel here in the center console, and then you see a USB-A and a USB-C port down here. So taking a look at the mirror controls in the new Tundra, of course you do have this little toggle for left and right. You've got a button to fold the mirrors, and then you've got a mode called auto, which means when you get out and lock the truck, the mirrors will fold automatically. So I've hopped out, locked the truck, and there go the mirrors. So when we go to look at the back seat of the Tundra, some interesting things you'll notice. Now this is of course the hybrid equipped iForce Max model. The hybrid battery lives underneath the rear seat, but so does the 12 volt battery. So if we lift up on this little plastic panel here, it's kind of tricky without a tool, but I can make it work. There we go. You can see there is your 12 volt battery. So lots and lots and lots of other stuff I didn't mention in the new Toyota Tundra, but they really have gone crazy with the insane gadgets and gizmos in this truck. A lot more tech than the previous generation. Like look, even the front emblem has been hollowed out for aerodynamics and for cooling capability. So love that Toyota has put in a huge effort in modernizing and improving the brand new Toyota Tundra. Be sure to stay tuned. I think hopefully soon Andre's gonna have some real thorough towing test back in Colorado on this new Tundra, but I had a quick chance to kind of check it out here in California on this actually Toyota hybrid drive program. And they brought out the Tundra because of course the iForce Max is equipped with the hybrid system, 437 horsepower, over 500 pound-feet of torque. But yeah, lots and lots of nice details. Really glad that Toyota has gone all out with the brand new Tundra. Let me know what you guys think in the comments section below. And as always, this has been Tommy with the Fastlane Car, the Fastlane Truck, and the Fastlane Off-Road. Check out TVLTruck.com for the latest and greatest in Tundra reviews.